Good morning, Facebook and YouTube viewers. I am Rebecca Sosmirsky with the Register Mail, and I am here today at WGIL with Roger Lundeen. And Roger, can you say talk a little bit about where we are right now and who comes in here in the mornings?
Well, we're in the WGIL main control room studio. This is where we anchor and host all of our local hours of content on WGIL. We're live in our morning show from 5 a.m. until 9 a.m. here, and then again at 5 p.m. to 6 p.m. for our evening news, and then on Saturday mornings as well. So anytime there's no syndicated shows on, the studio is where we are. So our morning show with Tom and Nick and Tyler here, and then the evenings with Will Stevenson are anchored here. And we bring in many community guests, and this is kind of where all the WGIL stuff happens.
That's awesome. And we were talking a little bit earlier about the localized content and how it kind of got started in the 60s and 70s with sports. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, obviously WGIL has been a local station for 80 years, but and have carried lots of high school sports, like many other local community stations, but it's been a really big deal in this community, and it continues to be a little bit, but not like what we saw in the 60s, 70s, early 80s. But we've been a big supporter of high school athletics, particularly high school, originally basketball and football, and then we added girls basketball in the 90s as well, and now we continue to broadcast all, you know, all those games with a huge following and with some really good talent. We've had excellent talent in doing play-by-play, and it's been a big priority for us to have some really good on-air people covering the high school events, and currently the on-air teams have been probably as good as ever.
That's great. And how else has the content kind of changed over the years in terms of local and what you guys focus on?
Well, we've been local forever. Now it's all about attention spans. There's so much competition with satellite radio options, with streaming options, with 500 cable TV channels that people might watch that are all doing different things, with Netflix and Hulu and podcasts and everything else that's out there. We know that there's a lot of choices, and for local radio to continue, obviously local is important, but paying attention to attention spans, people, keeping people interested for a few minutes at a time, maybe that extends to hours at a time, we hope. That's our number one goal in today's competitive media world, is finding things that are interesting and mostly local to talk about, that our audience can relate to and feel like they're informed.
Sure, and the radio hosts have to keep up with a lot, like listen to a lot of radio and everything to do that. What skills would you say the best hosts have for on air?
Well, probably for the last 20 years, the skills we look for and that we see are the most successful are certainly people with great storytelling abilities. Behind the scenes, it's a little more about writing things that are relatable to the audience, that are interesting, and kind of things that might catch the ear a little bit as far as promotions and commercials and things like that. But on the air, finding most of our hosts are local, so we don't have a lot of producers, so they're out researching themselves things that they think are interesting. Whether it's something that happened at the city council meeting this week, or something they might have seen in a nearby newspaper or website, or some community event going on in the area or nearby, or state politics, which is a lot of fun lately. Just things that we think affect people's lives, or at least makes their day go a little bit better if they find out about these things.
Sure. My last question, kind of going off of that, what's been your favorite story you've seen this week on WGIL?
Ooh, this week? That's a really good question. Obviously, one of the most interesting things here, maybe the best story this week, is the adding of new jobs. Jupiter project that Pegasus and Ray Whitehead is involved in. Anytime we can add good, what appears to be good high-paying jobs to our community is a positive thing for us. We know that economic development's important in the community. We need our community to do really well. It helps all of us. So those things are certainly things we cover a lot and we want to be a part of.
Sure, something that really affects the community mm-hmm. too. Awesome. Well, thank you, Roger, for being with us here today and showing us where the magic happens.
All right, my pleasure. Thanks for being here.
For sure. Thank you, readers, or viewers, for joining in.